H2K Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing, and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys, how we are different from our competitors. 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus, one-time fee and lifetime access to classes, access to recorded sessions of live classes. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For a free demo class, visit us at h2kinfosys.com.
First, the driver logic. Okay. So here today we are going to understand first of all with recording. With recording, I mean in Selenium IDE we will record a script and we will export into Java format. Okay. So here when I say with recording means in Selenium IDE we will record it. Okay, record and export here, export to Java format. Okay, once it is exported to Java format, we will try to understand the recorded script in Java format. Okay. Is my voice clear? Is my voice clear? Okay, fine. Okay, great. So here with recording. Okay, this is all with recording. So we'll record and we'll export into Java format. Then we'll try to understand the script that is in the Java format, how it goes. Okay. Then we'll try to do the same thing without recording. Okay. So in real time, this is important. So in real time, in Selenium or in generally functional automation, generally we will not record. We have to write our own scripts. Okay, so this is important. So, however, we'll start with recording. Now, before we go with recording, any suggestions on the applications? When you want me to take any particular application? I used to take a deal for loans, one application. Any suggestions on that? eBay, okay. Amazon. Let us take one application here. Let's see. Yeah, probably we'll take Southwest. Even observer will go to this website. Now everyone observe here in the Southwest website. Okay. Okay, we'll see. If it is going to be repeat, let me know, Harita. Give me a minute. See here in the Southwest website under this air, probably will select this one way. Okay. It seems it is not working. Oh, it's working here. See, I will enter some. New York. And then we'll enter this Los Angeles. Okay. we'll keep some date here and we'll click on search. This we'll try to do a kind of search over here, okay? A simple search. Okay. So now everyone observe here, tools, Selenium IDE. Okay. File, new test case, and see I'm clicking record button. Okay, let me select round trip, and here selecting New York. Okay, and here we'll enter this Los Angeles. We'll see how it is going to record. Okay, then we'll click on search. So till this point I just recorded it here. Okay, now I'll stop this. Now we'll try to replay this, how it is going to replay. Okay, now see here I'm just executing in a bit slow mode. We'll see whether it is going to execute properly or not. Something went wrong here. Fine. Actually, if you close the screen in this script, it did not record entering the values here. Okay. It has selected the wrong trip. Then we were entering this this text field, right? Fine. Let me take another sample scenario. We'll come back to this. I know for this we need to put some extra effort right away. I don't want to stress you as of now. We'll go with a different simple scenario here. Okay. We'll come back to this scenario after a bit time, not now. Okay. Yep. So here we'll click on the sign up and save. Okay. We'll enter some fields here. Okay. First name, last name, email address, this home airport. Okay. We'll click on the submit. Okay. We'll try to do a kind of a registration kind here. So now let me go to the Southwest. Let me take a new test case. I'm just recording here. So I'm clicking on this sign up and save. First name I'm entering ABC. Last name DVF. ABC@DVF.com. Submit. Okay. Now we'll go here and we'll stop the recording. Okay. This is a script which is recorded as part of the recording. Okay. Now we'll try to replay. Now see, I'm just replaying, observing the background. Where it is executing. Oh. Yep, let me execute one more time. It was happening in the back. Yep. See here. Now it is opening this. It is entering first name, last name, email address, home address. It has selected the checkbox and clicked on submit. Okay. Now if you look at here, it's showing a green color bar and the center thing is highlighted in here. The background is highlighted in a green color. Okay. Now see here, this is a script that we have recorded as part of Selenium IDE. Okay. Now see here, we will try to export into Java flavor. Okay. So here I'm exporting to Southwest. Okay. And let me say first web driver Southwest. Okay. I'm exporting to this particular folder here. Let me open the clips here. So we just recorded a script in Selenium IDE and we exported into a Java format. Okay. Now we will try to understand this Java program, because we have been learning Java, right? Now we will try to see whether we are able to interpret the exported Java format or not. You don't need to export this. Actually here it did not record the click on the sign up and save. Why does not record this? Give me it. New test case. Now here I'm clicking on report. And save. Here I'm just recording because it was not recorded that link. Somehow it is not recording, it is okay. We'll look into that. Come on. So basically what we have done, here we have opened the southwest.com, right? And suddenly we clicked on click on sign up and save. Right. Enter first name, last name, email, ID, select home airport and select accept the condition. Click on submit. Okay. So these are the steps that basically we have automated now. Now this is the exported Java format. So first web driver Southwest. So let me copy this. I am pasting over here. Now let me expand this. Now see here. Now the first line basically it is because of the Selenium IDE settings. Okay, just delete this. Now everyone agree here. Now what is the purpose of this inputs? What is the purpose of the inputs? We have discussed it, right? What is the main purpose of inputs? It is something like linking the library files to our script, right? So it means here in the script we have used some set of some Java related or something extra. Okay, for them we are linking the library files, we are linking the library related information to our script, our Java program. Okay. Then if you all look at here, what we have understood in a class, what we are going to have in a class, what we are going to have class variables and methods, right? Class variables and methods. Now if you closely look at this program here, if you closely look at here, you can find class variables, okay, and methods here, right? The format, whatever we understood in our previous Java, now you are able to see the same thing. We know what is the use of imports. Imports is like if you use any special logic, or if you use anything like some existing Java classes, we are going to link those library files over here to our program. Okay, and in a class, we know there will be class variables and methods. Now we are able to see the same thing here. Now, if you look at this here, can you see here @ before? What is this @ before? What is this @ before? It's annotation, right? And what is this throws exception? Okay. Now see here, @ test. Okay. So now whatever we have recorded, okay, it's been showing over here. Okay. So simple. However, well, now we are going to understand this. However, we are going to understand this. Okay. But in overall, no, this is what we have done. Okay. So it's in higher level. When you look at the this program for the first time, okay, during the demos, probably this is going to be like a kind of a monster. But you know, once you learn the Java, once you get into the details, but basically it is very easy. Okay. Now you have recorded. We have recorded and we have explored into Java, and we try to understand the overall structure of Java Java over here. Okay. Now we'll try to write the same logic without recording. Okay. We'll try to write the same logic without recording. Okay. Yeah. So these are the steps basically. We are trying to automate these 6 steps without recording. Okay. Now everyone observe. Let me go here. Let me see. New class. Now everyone agree here. Now here onwards we are going to make use of locators, and if I want to know the locators of a particular application, what I have to use? See here, first of all I'm writing a method here, public void, let me say Southwest signup. Okay. Good. Now what is our first step? Our first step is this. We have to open our launch. Right. This is our first step. Now before this, what we have to do? If I want to open or launch this southwest.com, first what we have to do? We have to open the application, right? We have to open the browser, right? So first step is open the, let me say, Firefox browser. Okay. So first of all, we have to open a Firefox browser, then we have to open this this application. Okay. Now if any one of you get confused, please let me know right away. Okay, this is going to be important. So first of all, we have to open the browser, then we have to open the southwest.com. Okay. Now here for opening the browser. Now everyone try to understand the logic here. First of all, we have to open the browser. So here in Selenium, Webdriver, there are some set of classes. If you remember in our previous class, here I was explaining about Webdriver, right? Selenium Webdriver interface. I said here we are going to have Internet Explorer, Firefox, Google Chrome. For Internet Explorer, we have some class called Internet Explorer Driver. Okay. And for Firefox, we have Firefox Driver. Okay, the class name here technically, okay, here we have Internet Explorer Driver. This is the class which was implemented, which implements all these methods here. Okay, for Google Chrome, we have Chrome Driver. Okay, now see here I want to open a Firefox browser. Now see here I'm saying I'm going to create an instance here. How to create the instance? Be interactive. Yep, that's correct. Yep. Here Firefox Driver class name. Okay. Here object name. Let me say OBRW. I mean to say it's a browser. Okay. Then new Firefox Driver. Okay, so this is a line. The line that I have highlighted over here, it is going to open a browser here. Okay, now as of now, let us try to execute this script. Okay, now if I want to execute this script, what I have to do? If I want to execute this particular method here, what we can do here? Okay. We can use annotation. And we can use at the request type. Okay. Now I'm using JUnit annotation. Okay. Now everyone up there here. Now as per our logic, what it has to do, it has to open a Firefox browser. And that to be an empty Firefox browser. Okay, now the now whatever the logic that we have mentioned here, because of that logic, it's going to open an empty Firefox browser. For the first time in the day, it is going to take a bit time. Yep, see here. Now it has opened an empty Firefox driver here. Okay, here now it has opened an empty Firefox, and here this is a web driver. Okay, although you know what I'm saying here, see here Firefox driver, which is a package, which is a part of Selenium web driver. That is what you know, yesterday session we have discussed. Can you see here there is an import selenium.firefox.firefoxdriver. It means this is a class which is already exist in the Selenium Webdriver. Okay, we did not create it. It's already there. We are making use of it. Okay. Now here we are successful in opening the Firefox browser. Now what we have to do? After that we want to open this website, right? Now in a similar way, suppose if you want to open an Internet Explorer, what you have to do here, everyone observe here, Internet Explorer driver. Okay. Again same kind of like you can say Internet Explorer again, Internet Explorer driver. Okay. Or if you want to use, yeah, we have to use Microbot. Say if you want to use a Google Chrome, Chrome driver, okay, oh, Chrome driver, new, okay. So in a similar way, if you want to open other browsers, you can write the logic here. Again, however, we'll come back to this. Okay, once we understand this, we'll come back to this. So as of now, we are opening a Firefox browser. We are just opening a plain empty Firefox browser like this. Okay. Now we close this. After that, what we actually wanted to do, we want to launch this particular southwest.com, right? So now to launch that southwest.com, see here, for this object, if you remember yesterday, these classes, Firefox driver, Internet Explorer, Chrome, or whatever the browsers, all these browsers has implemented the Webdriver instant Webdriver interface methods. Now here for this class, we are going to have a method called get. Okay, basically if you want to open any URL, if you want to open any application, here you have to mention this get method. You have to use a get method here. Yesterday I was in sample, I was saying that open a URL application, right? If you want to open a URL, you are going to use a get method here. Technically, Webdriver is going to have a get method that was implemented in Firefox. Okay, that was implemented in Firefox. Now, as of now, I'm using a get method of Firefox, but that get indirectly it is part of Selenium Webdriver because they have implemented them over here. However, in simple, come back and see if you want to open an application, you have to use a get. Okay. Now here we have to mention the URL, right? Now let me copy this. Now everyone observe here, you have to mention HTTP this one. Okay. If you don't mention, basically this application will not open properly. Okay. Make sure when you mention a URL, make sure you are going to mention HTTP. Which is, you know, when I was learning Selenium, I spent 2 days to figure out the issue. I did not mention HTTP and I wrote the logic. And no, I was not finding out the issue. When I look at the script, everything is good. So after 2 days, I found the issue. During my initial days, so I missed that HTTP. HTTP is very important. So here you have to mention HTTP for the URL before opening the URL. You have to mention HTTP here. Now we'll try to execute it again. Now see here. Now what we have to do, if we execute this, what it is going to do? Now if we execute this this method, what it is going to do? That's correct, Anil. Now it is going to open a Firefox browser and then it is going to open a Southwest application. Now see here, it is opening a Firefox browser, then it is trying to open the Southwest application here. Okay, and if you look at here the corner, it is showing Webdriver here. Okay, now it has opened the Southwest app. Now, here, what is our third step? And we want to click on sign up and save, right? Now here, click on sign up and save, right? Now how can I do this? Okay, basically we want to click on sign up and save. Okay. Now let me give a bit explanation here. Now first of all, see here, everyone listen to this. If you want to do some operation on the application, whatever the tool might be, first of all, the tool should recognize it. Okay, first of all, the tool should recognize it. Once it recognizes, then it can perform the operation. Here, what is the operation? Here, the operation is click. If you remember in Selenium IDE, we were talking about the command target value. Did you remember this? Did you all remember this command target value in Selenium IDE? We have discussed. Yep. Now here, what is the command for this line? What is the command line command for this? Yep. The command for this is click. Okay. And the target. Target means where exactly we are doing. Command means what we are doing. Right. What? Target means where we are doing. So basically we are doing a sign up and save. Basically that is going to be a link. Okay, so here what we have to mention technically, did you remember the word? Here technically we have to use something, locator, right? Technically we are going to use locator here. Okay, this we call it as a locators. So here in our application, how can I find the locator of this object? I mean, it might be, what are the locators that we have discussed? First of all, what are the locators? What are the different locators that we have discussed? What are the different locators that we have discussed? Now see here, if you look at here, can you see this? We have discussed ID, name, link text, export, CSS, by tag name. Okay. Now again we are going back to this topic. Okay, that is where I said locators is very, very important concept. Okay. So here again we are going to use this these things to recognize the objects here. So now if we go here, okay. Now if you want to click on the sign up and save, okay. So basically we are going to use the locators. It might be ID, it might be name, it might be link text, it might be export, CSS. Okay, based on the availability of the objects here. I mean, based on the availability of the properties here. However, how can I find the locator of the sign up and save? I know it might be a link or it might contain some ID and all. How can I find the locator of this? Yep, that's correct. I can see some answers. Any some more guesses? Yep, that's correct. So if you remember, we have discussed a firebug. If you all observe here, again, if you want to analyze the UI objects, I mean, if you want to find the locators here, we are going to have a firebug, firepath. If it is in the IE browser, here we are going to have IE developer tools, which is a Chrome. We are going to have Chrome developer tools. Okay. However, I said, firebug is the most of the developers uses firebug. Okay, now basically again we are going back to our locators concept. So now here everyone agree here, right click on this object, and there will be inspect element with firebug. So I'm using that, and then I'm trying to identify, I'm trying to see the locators of this. Okay, now if you look at here, we don't have any ID, we don't have any name, and but if you probably, if you look at here, here it is bounded with A tag. A tag means, if it is bounded with A tag, what is it, what does it mean? It is going to be a link. Okay, it's going to be a link. Whenever anything is bounded with A tag, that is called as a link. Of course, technically we call A means anchor. Okay, so now if you look at here, the sign up and save is a link. So I'm taking this. Okay, so as per our understanding, first of all, our Selenium should recognize the object. First, whatever it want to do here, first Selenium has to recognize the object, then it has to perform the operation. Okay. Selenium has to recognize the object. Okay. Then it has to perform the operation. Okay. Now here, first of all, we'll try to understand how Selenium is going to recognize the object in Selenium WebDriver. Now everyone observe here, for recognizing an object in Selenium WebDriver here, now everyone observe here. So here, first of all, we will understand recognizing. First of all, we'll try to see how it is going to recognize it. Okay. Now here, OBrowser dot, there is a method called find element. Okay. Everyone observe here, I'm using a method called find element. Okay. How we are trying to recognize it? By using link text, right? Link text. Okay. So we were using a link, right? What is the locator? We identified that sign up and save as a link. So that is where we are going to use link text here. Okay. Yep. Now everyone observe here, this is the highlighted line which will help in recognizing the object. Okay. The highlighted line which is going to help us in recognizing the sign up and save in the application. Okay. Now after recognizing, what we want to do, we want to click right. So what you can do here, this highlighted line basically it is going to recognize the object. Once it recognizes, I want to click on it. Okay, there will be a method called click. Okay, any questions on this line? Any questions here? Any questions? If it is clear for you, please mention it as clear. As I said, it is important. Okay, if you have any small question, or it might be small or big, question is question. If you have any questions, please mention over here. Okay. Nashin, if you observe here, I copied from here. We spied it, right? You know, here I said right click on the object, and I said inspect with element with firebug, and it got something like this. And here I copied and I pasted over here. Okay. Good. What's your question, Anil? Anil, what is your question? Okay, I can see here your question. If it is the actual scenario, we will not know the link ID earlier, right? Yes, even in this case also, I did not consider it as a link, right? I spied it and I understand that it is a link. Even I did not directly conclude that it is a link. First of all, I have right clicked, okay, and I said inspect with element, and then I come here, First of all, I looked at ID. ID was not there, and then name was not there, and I observed that it is a link. How I observed? By looking at this A tag. I concluded that this is a link here. Okay, so that is the process that I have followed. Okay, first of all, if you remember, I said, you know, we don't have the ID. I said we don't have the name. Then I said it contains A tag, so it is a link. So we can take the link text locate here. Okay. Is it clear, Anil? Of course, even if it is not identifying as a link, then we have to depend on XPath or CSS. Alga is asking, in the last line included two methods. Yes, it's a combination of two methods. That's correct, Alga. First of all, we are identifying it. First of all, we are identifying it and then we are clicking in it. Yes. Then Anjan, there is a link is more than one place in the page. How can we identify that? If Anjan is asking a good question here, what Anjan is asking here we have sign up and save, right? So the same link is presented somewhere in the other, I mean in the same page, say here it is also presented. The same link, the sign up and save, here also it is presented. In that case, how Selenium can distinguish this sign up and this sign up? Yes, in that case, we have to depend on XPath, Anjan. Okay? If you want to differentiate, the first sign-in with the second sign-in, you have to use the XPath concept. We'll come back to that topics, okay? Give a minute, Anil. Now we are successful. Now we'll try to execute again the script. Okay. So now we have added one more line, right? Like opening the Firefox browser and then opening the southwest.com, then clicking on the sign up and save. We have wrote the steps to that point, right? Now we'll try to execute the same thing over here. Now see here it is opening Southwest. First of all, it has opened the Firefox. Then it has opened Southwest. Then it has to click on sign up and save here. Now can you all observe here? It clicked on sign up and save. They are getting to this page. If you look at here, there is a web driver here. Okay. Now, however, after that, what is our test case? It is asking us to enter first name, last name, email ID, right? So I just write down in a single step, but basically these are the three steps, right? Like first name, last name, email ID. Now if I want to enter, now can you all guide me how can I proceed here? Can you guide me here? Now first what I have to do? First we have to recognize the object, right?
O browser dot find element.
Yeah. You can post here in chat box, Devon. We'll see how the others are going to respond. Okay. Yeah. Thanks, Devon. Yep. Any guesses here? Say, first of all, I want to enter first name. Now, can you all post your guesses over here? Now, I want to enter the first name. What you want me to do here? Mm-hmm. I don't see any responses. Either you don't understand or you don't want to answer the question. Yep. First of all, we have to recognize it. How can I recognize it? Yeah, we can go here. Right. Here, now click on this. Okay. Now see here, we want to enter first name. So what I have to do here? How can I find the locator of this? Right click, inspect element with firebug. Okay. Now here, see here whether you have an ID or name. See, first of all, you have ID. So I can take this ID. Okay. Now I can take this ID. Okay, I took this ID. Then what you want me to do here? This instance dot, first of all we have to recognize. How can I recognize? Using find element, we can recognize it. And using find element, by what we are going to recognize? By ID we are going to recognize, right? So by using ID we are going to recognize it. So I am saying first name here. So this is the highlighted line. This is the highlighted line which will help us to recognize the first name here. Once it recognized here, we basically we want to enter, right? So here for entering a method called send keys. Okay. If you want to enter any value, if you want to enter any value here in Selenium, we have a method called send keys here. Okay. So here, see here. Let me enter ABC here. Okay. Now everyone observe here. Here we are recognizing this first name and then we are entering. And one of the best practices here, you know, if you are trying to enter any value into this one, what we say, this text boxes. Okay. If you are trying to write, if you are trying to enter any value into the text boxes, okay, if you are trying to enter any value into the text boxes, make sure first you are going to clear it. Clear it in a sense, by default there might be some first name. Like, so it is preferable to first clear it. It means delete this content, existing content, delete the existing content and enter your new content. So for that, again, what I'm trying to say, first you have to clear and you have to enter. Okay. So for that, there is another method here. See here. Clear, I'm clearing it and then I'm entering the value here. Okay. Now in a similar way, I want to do a last name. Now can you all guide me? Now I want to enter a last name here. What we can do here? Now I want to enter a last name here. What I have to do here? See, I am taking the last name here. I am taking the ID here. So I am taking this instance, this browser instance, that find element by ID. Last name, then first of all I want to clear it. If we have any content, I want to clear it. Okay, then I want to enter the content here. Okay, here let me say DVF. Okay, and in a similar way if you want to enter the email address, just buy this. Find this email. Okay, first of all I am recognizing it, then I am clearing it. Okay, and see here I am entering send keys. Okay, here abc@dgf.com. Okay, so I have entered the email ID here. Then here we have to select a drop down. For selecting a value in a drop down, it is a bit different. Okay, I mean it is not the straightforward way like what we have understood here. Okay, it's not the same way, it's not the direct way. Okay, here as of now I'm writing a logic. Okay, we'll come back to this logic a bit later. Okay, I will explain this later. Okay, you know, selecting a value in the list box, it's a bit different here. As I said, I will explain a bit later. Say I want to select something else here, something like so I'm selecting this. Okay. Then here I want to click on this checkbox. So see here, I'm selecting, I'm identifying this, and it has some ID, IAN. So now let me go here. Now some conditions checkbox. Okay, so again a browser dot find element by ID. Okay, so you directly click. If you want to select a checkbox here, you can directly click, and then if you want to click on submit, okay, here, see here I'm identifying this, and it has ID, submit. Here, our browser, find element by ID. Dot click. Okay. Fine. Now see here, this is how I have automated the same scenario without recording. Okay. So the key element is here, find element. Okay. By find element, first of all, we are recognizing it. Once we recognize it, then we are performing the operation here. Okay. Now I did not explain only these two lines. We'll discuss in coming classes. We'll understand this. Okay. Now we'll try to execute this. Now see here. Now see here, that is opening southwest. Now it has to click on sign up and save. And as of now, the browser is not maximized, right? Okay, even we can write a logic to maximize the browser. And moreover, if you observe here, see here, it is thrown an error. What happened here? Once it clicked on the sign up and save, once it clicked on sign up and save, it seems it was taking some time. Okay, application was taking some time, so it seems it could not identify this one. Okay, what I'm saying here, once it clicked on the sign up and save, okay, it seems immediately application is not turned up. Okay. Selenium was not find this first name. Here, what we can do, if that's correct, Devon, any guesses? If that's correct, Sri, what we have to do here, we have to keep some wait time. If you remember yesterday, we have discussed this thread dot sleep. Say here, let me say some 3000. Okay, now our script is going to wait for three seconds over here. Now let me use this throws declaration. Okay, and moreover, if you remember, I said if any one of the object is not identified by the Selenium. Okay, if you remember, see here, there is a exception like no such element exception. Okay, it is throwing an error, no such element exception. Okay, now let us try to execute this. Now let me close this browser, and even I said we can maximize this browser, right? As of now, when the browser is open, it is opening in this mode. Okay, I want to maximize this browser. For this, there is a logic. See here, once the browser is open, yeah, see here, this is a logic. virtual maximize the browser. Okay, so what we are basically doing, this is the browser instance. Okay, so basically we are managing. What we are managing? We are managing window. So in window, what you want to do? Maximize. Okay, just remember this. Now see here, now if we execute this, now see, it has opened an empty browser, maximized. Now it has to click on sign up and save. Okay, after that it should wait for 3 seconds. Okay, then it has to enter first name, last name. Again it thrown as a, probably let me keep some wait, more wait time. Let me keep some 7. Now, if you can write the same logic from your end, okay, if you can write the same logic from your end by your own, just if you can write the same logic from your end, I can say you are completed around 60 to 70% of the Selenium. I mean, out of 100% of the Selenium, you are done with 60 to 70% of Selenium. Now it has to wait for 7 seconds and then it has to enter this first name, last name. Then why it is getting to another? Game net. We have given plenty of time, right? Okay, we'll discuss in next session. We'll see, probably we'll execute in a debug mode. Okay, and again, I'm just guessing, here when we click on this, this sign up and save, when we click on this, basically it is getting into some, this HTTPS mode and some kind of a warning is appearing. Okay, we'll see. Actually, I'm running out of time. I have another session.
H2K Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing, and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys, how we are different from our competitors. 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus, one-time fee and lifetime access to classes, access to recorded sessions of live classes. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For a free demo class, visit us at h2kinfosys.com.